Hello friends, today in this video we are going to see about the topic epidemiology of communicable diseases. So in the communicable diseases, it may be classified under 7 classifications: respiratory, intestinal, arthropod borne, zoonosis, surface, emerging and re-emerging, and hospital acquired. Now in this video we are going to see about the respiratory infection, mainly the smallpox. Smallpox, which is already eradicated all over the world, but we have to know about the clinical features and the treatment and modalities just taken to eradicate the smallpox. First is smallpox. Smallpox is caused by the organism variola virus. It is caused by the virus, which is variola virus. And then clinical features of smallpox. In smallpox, the fever, which is sudden onset of fever. In this fever, the third day of fever, first the fever would be sudden onset, then on the third day of fever, rashes develop in the smallpox, which is different from that of the chickenpox. In chickenpox, fever and rashes develops at the same time. Here on the third day of fever, rash develops. Then the following features: headache, backache, and vomiting. These three are common for both smallpox and chickenpox. And then convulsions. In case of children, convulsions occur in smallpox. And rash. Already I said, on the third day of fever, the rash develops. The rash passes through these following stages. First stage, which is macule, then papule, vesicle, pustule, which then develops into a scab with subsequent scarring. These are the stages of the rashes, and the rash is centrifugal in nature. Centrifugal means first it appears in the periphery, mainly the face and arms, and then it spreads to the center trunk. So this is centrifugal in nature. Here, the armpits are free of rashes. This is a feature of smallpox, and in case of chickenpox, the armpits would be affected. Then incubation period. Incubation period of smallpox varies from 7 to 17 days, and average is being 12 days. In chickenpox, the burden of chickenpox here we have discussed. The last case of chickenpox was mentioned on 24th May 1975. This is in India, and smallpox free country India is declared on 5th July 1975, and it was confirmed by April 1977. Throughout the world, the smallpox was eradicated, and it is confirmed by May 1980. So we have to finalize that smallpox is completely eradicated, and throughout the world it was mentioned on May 1980. Next we are going to see about the case discussion under the International Health Regulation 2005 Act. Then the confirmed case of smallpox has the following features, which includes acute onset of fever. So as I already said, the fever is acute onset, which is greater than 38.3 degrees Celsius or 101 degree Fahrenheit. Now this fever may come at any age, so age is not a barrier for this. Along with that fever, malaise would be present. Then severe prostration with headache and backache. These are the features of a smallpox to confirm it as a case of a smallpox. Along with this, other two features, which includes development of maculopapular rash. As I already mentioned, it is centrifugal in nature. First it arises in the face and forearm, then in the trunk and legs. Then with this, the deep-seated, firm, hard, round, well-circumscribed vesicles will be presented in these regions. First it appears as a maculopapular rash, and then it develops into a vesicles. Then the vesicles turns into pustules, which later turns into scab. This is another feature of that smallpox confirmation. First I said fever with the malaise and other features. Second one I said maculopapular rashes, which then converts into vesicles, and finally into pustules. Third feature in this is appeared lesions in a particular area. If you see in a face or trunk or leg, in that region you can see only a particular stage of development will be seen at that region, either macules or papules or vesicles. If the vesicle is found in that region, means the whole region, in the trunk region fully, there will be vesicles only. No macules or papules will be seen in that region. Then no alternate diagnosis explaining this condition. So first we said fever, then the rashes. Third one, the rashes should be of a particular stage in the region. The fourth one is there should be no other alternate diagnosis explaining the condition of illness. So if the condition is prior to diagnosing as another condition, then it does not come under smallpox. You have to keep that in mind. No other disease should be diagnosed as this disease. Then by laboratory confirmation, these five features confirms that the case is of a smallpox. First one we saw fever with acute malaise. Then we saw the development of the maculopapular rashes. Development of maculopapular rashes, face and forearm, then spreads to the trunk and legs, then the vesicles formation, then pustules. Then the appeared lesions should be at the same stage of development in a particular region of a body. Then no alternate diagnosis should be explaining this illness, and the laboratory confirmation. All these shows that the smallpox is confirmed. But now, at the present, from May 1980, throughout the world, smallpox is eradicated, and the virus is tagged in American and Russian research institutes if any further infection occurs throughout the world, like a pandemic. Now corona coming along that way. If any pandemic occurs with that smallpox, millions of vaccines and sample viruses are stored in these research centers to prevent this pandemic attack. Thank you.